Hey guys, Street Smart Joker here. Today is the day number 5 of the coronavirus lockdown here in India. And today I thought, let me bring you something special from the mythos of Batman. A story arc which is not quite as famous as something like a Nightfall or No Man's Land or even the New 52 Run. So this is a story arc which not many people would have heard about or know about. Different opinions are there around it. Maybe it's not quite as spectacular as the other ones, or it's kind of like a rip-off from No Man's Land. Multiple theories go on around it, but still I thought it's a good time for us to go and bring about this storyline, and I would suggest it's a good storyline for many of you guys who are Batman collectors especially to definitely give a try. So the one I'm going to give you and show you today is this series, right? You could see it. It's called Batman War Series. It consists of Batman War Drums, Batman War Games Act 1, which is Outbreak, War Games Act 2 Tides, and War Games Act 3, which is Endgame. And then there is a epilogue kind of series called War Crimes. So the good part is I've got all of this. It took me some time to get it all, but I did get all of them. So, quick, what I'm going to do is take them one by one, arrange them here in, and give you a snapshot of the covers, and then we'll start talking more in depth of what this actually contain, right? I hope all you guys are stay safe and happily enjoying your holidays. Just give me a sec. All of these are pretty tightly packed. Yes. So that is the series. So we begin by going to Batman War Drums, which is actually a prequel to the War Games, which is the entire three-part, three-trade paperback part run. And then we finally end up with War Crimes. So it's all tagged by the war is the keyword here. Just to give you an idea, all this, see, for example, these covers are also very interestingly, it captures, see, in this one, you could see all the characters put in place to where the war is starting. And then it moves to the characters in action. At least the main characters, once they move into action, sorry for the glare, and then we move into the final end game, right, when they bring out all the hidden players and stuff, and then War Crimes. So this arc ran between, obviously, Detective Comics. It covered Batman, it covered Batgirl, it covered Legends of the Dark Knight, Nightwing, Robin, Catwoman, Gotham Central, Gotham Knights, a set of, so it was all put in place between 2 years, 2004 to 2005, and this finally ran into, I think, Infinite Crisis. It was the kind of like, it tapered towards, and the Infinite Crisis started, I think, right after this, or slightly before this, like something in that window. Right, so let's take them one by one and see what they have in store for us. So this is the starting book. It's called War Drums, as you guys can see. One of the things that I wanted to point out to you is that this trade packs is actually having a newspaper print kind of paper. So it's not the best quality paper out there, which is a sad part. Only the last one, which is Batman War Crimes, which you can see here, is the only one which has the glossy paper print. And from what I know, it was not printed as part of this trilogy or four-set series of War Games. It was printed separately, it came at a later date. Maybe that's why it has a much better paper quality. Right, so this is where it all began. I'm sure you could see the cover page, which has all the characters there. That's Tarantula, then we have Orpheus, we have Robin, which is the female Robin, Stephanie Brown, we have Oracle, and I think that's pretty much it. I can't place the name of this character. So you go behind it, it will say that it all starts with a small skirmish, right? So this story is a prequel to the War Games story. It brings all the characters and puts a context to the entire thing. And the biggest highlight, as you could see, is war is coming to Gotham City, right? So unlike No Man's Land, where the entire skirmish and problem started with an earthquake and then the whole gangs getting involved, this has a different context, which is good. Although it runs in the same veins on what chaos could, happen to Gotham if the gangs go haywire, right? So there is a just to give you a backstory, a talented pop star goes missing, and Leslie Tompkins, for those of you who doesn't know, she is a doctor, and she was the one who took Bruce under her care when after his parents died, because he came to her clinic for a checkup to see if he is fine after the outbreak. And there is also a storyline which I've heard about, in which even here it shows that there is some relationship between her and Pennyworth, Alfred Pennyworth, right? Which is not very overtly shown here, but still there is some backgrounds to that, right? It is a story in which Stephanie Brown is the Robin, and although for only a short while, and Tim Drake has given up his Robin identity just to give a backdrop, and Stephanie Brown till now was known as Spoiler. I'll show you her in the next pages, but in this book she gets to wear the Robin Robin call for a short duration, right? And that sets the context for the entire story going ahead. Like I said, nothing great for the paper quality, as you guys can see. I will try to show some if there is some great artwork, some cover pages here, right? And some artwork. So the artwork, this I feel that some of the artwork is like quite cartoonish in some of the stories, not everything, but it keeps, because there is a bunch of writers and bunch of artists and inkers working on this. That's why there is a huge shift in the artwork. I believe if you could see this artwork, right, it's quite brilliant. Now the one I showed you earlier was very amateurish. So that's what it does, right? This story, it throws out a lot of brilliance in terms of artwork and storytelling, and then it throws out some duds along the way. So it's quite mixed bag. The book is pretty big, if you could see, right? It's a big storyline. So it has a bunch of writers. I could show you some of them, or I could take you to the first page and show you, right? So the binding is, it's not very strong. It's kind of like loosened and it's coming off, so I had to stick it back. It has Ed Brubaker, one of my favorite writers, but the main ones are Anderson, Gabrish, Bill Willingham, and then there are a bunch of pencil artists, right? Tim Sale is there, you could see, for a bit of original covers, right? So that's where it begins, and they give you a backdrop of what other stuff has happened leading to this. There's no Commissioner Gordon in this. He does make some guest appearances, but mostly it is Commissioner Atkins who is at play. So there are some groundwork you need to do before starting to read it, right? And then you jump right into the story. I'm showing you some panels, right? If you could see this panel, it's quite a brilliant panel. That's where the death of a pop star starts, and I think of a drug addict starts, and then Batman jumps in. The characters start jumping in to see what is actually happening. Just showing you some panels, nothing much to tell you about in this, but I like this story. I like the way it has been structured, and it shows a lot of detective work. It shows that some of the stories do need a lot of context setting and backdrop stories, etc. So here you will see a backdrop story for Leslie Tompkins, whom I was just speaking about earlier. and how Bruce thinks back to the days when he was small and they used to visit Leslie at her operations in faraway lands, right? So beautiful panel works all around here. You could see this panel very clearly, right? Quite brilliant artwork in this. So no complaints there, and that quite hooked me into this storyline. In fact, I don't want to make this video too long, but there are multiple parts into this. It brings about Orpheus as a very central character early on, and he is also a Batman's ally. His play also is mentioned, right? It could take hours and hours for us to go through the entire story because the story is so big. Just some panels, and then we move into the territory where they bring in Batgirl out, and she's pretty important in the follow-on stories. They need her. And also how Stephanie Brown becomes the new Robin under Batman, right? That's the biggest turnaround that happens in this story, which is, I think, it shows Batman in a very poor light, right? Getting a teenager like her into the Robin costume when he himself knows that she is not fully ready, and then she takes her out to a bunch of missions. She starts acting on her own. He doesn't like it. Finally, fires her, and that too without no very strong reason. When she actually tried her best to keep Batman safe from none other than Victor Zsasz, right? He saved Batman, and for the same reason, he fires her, saying that she didn't obey his direct orders, right? I feel that writing becomes a bit awry in this storyline at times. Just to build up the plot, they have tinkered with the characters like Batman and some other characters, which you will realize later through the stories. Some beautiful covers here. I'm just showing you a couple of panels, right? That's Tarantula there, right? So beautiful panels, beautiful artwork. As a Batman fan, definitely yes, I would want to collect more of this stuff, no question about that. So that is, guys, Batman War Drums. If any of you guys want me to do a proper review, end to end, I'm definitely be game for that. But to do each of the review for each of this is going to take a long time. Then we move into the three-part series, starting with War Games Outbreak. Just to give you a backdrop of the story, Stephanie Brown, because she was fired as Robin, and basically there are spoilers, please. I cannot skip this without this, tell you more about this without telling you the spoiler part. She steals Batman's plans. The plan is around, Batman has a contingency plan for everything, and he has a plan where the city, if the city goes to chaos, he wants to take control of the entire mobs in the city, right? And he has a plan for that. She steals the plan and puts it into action. But the one big missing piece into that plan was actually Matches Malone. For those people who are Batman fans will know that is a Batman duel or trial, I don't know what. It's another identity for Batman essentially. And the idea was Matches Malone will take control of the entire gangs in Gotham, right? Unfortunately, she is not aware of this, and when she puts the plan into action, there's no Matches Malone there. And that creates all chaos, and there is a big massacre that happens because of all the crime lords coming at the same place based on Stephanie's invitation, and it kills multiple crime lords and crime just erupts. So there is a war that erupts in the city, and that is the entire storyline, right? Just showing you some panels from this book, right? I'll just take it and give you more closer look. Maybe you would like that. So these are some of the panels. That's Tarantula coming on her own. I've not heard of her character before, but like you could see clearly, even though it's a newspaper type paper quality, the visuals are quite good. I mean, it does dip in certain times when a different artist takes over or some stuff like that happens, but overall it's still good. It brings a lot of characters into play, lot of Batman vigilante family, the entire family comes into play, right? And then the only part I felt that drags me down in this is there are too many mafias fighting each other. I hardly have a sense to keep a tab of all the mafias that is out there. It's unlike Batman villains, which you could definitely know that there are some villains and they're so popular so you can keep track. But here there are multiple characters. So I quite honestly lost track of them. So it begins and then there are some deaths that happen. It moves to the next phase, which is tides, where Batman is desperately trying to take control of the situation. And a very beautiful panel, which I just saw in between. Yeah. Batman in the bike, and this is when things get more disastrous, as there is a new person in play, which is the Black Mask. And once he is in play, then the entire game goes for a toss, because Batman understood that it was his plan all along that is throwing this the whole city into war, and he knows how to take control. But all of a sudden he realized there is a new player in the game and he has taken control, right? So it goes beyond his grasp. There is a torture part here where Black Mask kidnaps Stephanie Brown and tortures her to hell. That's pretty pretty gory to see all that in this storyline, but it's pretty important. Catwoman has a role to play, and then it shows you different shades of Batman, the way he thinks, why he's a loner, and why it gets difficult even for the Bat family to work with him. It proves to be a challenge, right? Anyways, so the story then picks up a pace in this act two, right? And there are multiple storylines which keeps running in parallel, so you need to keep track on what's happening. And then we dive right into the last one, which is War Games Endgame, or seemingly the last one. Right, and I'll just put this one here. Again, artwork is brilliant. I couldn't stop reading after one point of time, because the story is just picked up and starts getting pace, and all the characters started coming to the fore, and they started showing glimpses of what they bring to the table. Right, I'm just trying to give you a glimpse of all this. I'm not trying to overdo it and tell you the entire story. But anyways, there is a sad, tragic death that happens at the end of this book. There are some twists and turns, and the ending is not the greatest ending that a Batman fan would love. It's quite a disastrous ending at the end of it all. I'm not going to spoil it here, right? But there are a lot of action in this book, right? I'm just going to show you some covers, right? Some brilliant covers. This is a brilliant one, right? It's from Matt Wagner, the Batman himself. Some brilliant covers there, right? So, Batman fan, definitely must pick up this storyline, right? Just showing you the back as well for some of the stories. And finally, we move into war crimes, right? So one of the things that I wanted was to get the entire set, right? No questions about that. And that is when that is the one here, Batman War Crimes, because the war drums ends on a pretty horrendous end, I would say. Not great for Batman and his gang. So War Crimes, I believe, is a perfect ending. And if not for this book, I would not have loved this series. So this is something which you definitely get. The good part about it is the paper becomes glossy, which I love, and the pages feel right much more better than the paper print which I showed you earlier. And obviously it picks up and gives you background on what happened and what needs to be done. It's like more of a peace period now that the war is over, and that's the difference between the other earlier books and this one. War is over, it's more of a search or a detective work now to figure out what exactly happened, why did things go wrong, right? And obviously my favorite is back in action, which is Joker himself. And he comes and he turns the tables for a few of the players who are already there. I simply would have loved he he was there in the earlier books, because this man would be the king of chaos, right? He would have killed all the chaos, would have run a different thing altogether, and I believe at some point he would have been perfect for the earlier storyline, because he's the one who could throw all the villains' plans into chaos, right? That's Joker for you, and that's why every story becomes so much more better when there is a Joker involved. Anyways, so this follows a story in which Batman investigates the death which I talked about in the last series, which is very close to him, and he was blamed for it up to a bit, and he wanted to set the game straight, right? And so he goes on an investigation to figure out what exactly happened, and finally he does nail down the actual culprit. Along the way, he also captures all the new mob boss. He catches them and hands them over to the police, and he finds it's a perfect ending. He figures out the unexpected killer, right? So some brilliant stuff in this book, and that's why I love this series. Just piling it off for you. So this is my entire run of Batman War Games. I'm just giving you a closer glimpse at the covers. Some brilliant covers, right? Popping out of the pages, as you guys could see. So I hope you guys liked it. And if there is any particular book in this series you want me to do a review on, I'll certainly be happy to do so. Although it's a bit of a drag, it takes some time and it takes a lot of reading for you to get into the action, I still love it because I'm a Batman fan at the end of it, and anything involving his family, some of the villains, a good plot to an extent, and some detective work and all those comes together in this book, and it's a 1 year arc, so I can understand why it's so long. So hope you guys like this review. Please do subscribe. Please do let me know if you guys like this, and I would continue doing and giving you more of such reviews in the future. Bye-bye. Have a safe time.